Hi, today AskF5 shows you how to troubleshoot and fix a big IP config file when the configuration file will not load. After an upgrade or restart, in the configuration utility, you may see this banner error message. The configuration has not yet loaded. If this message persists, it may indicate a configuration problem. If you see this error, the first thing to do is to log into the command line for your system and enter tmsh show sys MCP state. In the output, check the last configuration load status. If it does not say base config load failed, then you can ignore this error. However, if the error persists, or as in this example, it does show config load failed, then you should follow the steps set out in this video. Additionally, running phase should say running rather than platform, and the prompt should read active or standby rather than inoperative. So these also indicate that there is an issue. Note that there are numerous possible reasons for configuration errors, and the causes depend on your environment. This video walks you through the steps to troubleshoot and repair one such cause. The first step is to check to see if your license is activated. For more information, see this video. You can also refer to the articles linked in the description of this video if you have upgraded and there may be issues with the upgrade path. If licensing is not the issue, then the next step is to check the configuration file for misconfigured or missing objects. To do this, go to the command line and attempt to load the configuration by entering tmsh load sysconfig. The configuration fails to load because there is a reference to a missing file and there isn't a copy in the trash to restore from. Using grep, I will recursively search the config directory for the missing name by entering the following: grep r common dtdi cert config. The output shows the name of this file coming up in the big IP base config file. You can ignore the backup BAK files. I'm going to show the contents for that file by entering less and the file name big IP base conf. In the output, I'll look under cmcert common dtdi cert, since this is the name that failed in the configuration. In the cache path, it shows the entire path, so I'm going to block and copy that. At the command prompt, I'll enter ls and paste in the cache path. And sure enough, the output shows that the file is missing. I'll try again, but this time I'll take off the file name to look in the trust certificate D directory to see what files do exist in there. The output shows that there are three files in this directory, and one of them is common dtdi cert 64228_1. What we're looking for is the same name, except it is underscore 2. So we've discovered the problem. The configuration is looking for the second revision of the file rather than the first, so we have to fix that. To do so, we're going to edit the configuration file. But before we edit the configuration file, we must make a copy of the configuration file. This is critically important because if we somehow mess up that file, we'll need to go back to the original. So to do this, I'm going to copy the string, which I've included in the description of this video, and paste it here. This creates a copy of the config file appended with K0201043, which is the corresponding AskF5 knowledge base article for this video. Then I'll list the contents of the directory and make sure that the copy is there. As you can see, it's here. Now that I've got the copy saved, I can edit the big IP base config file using the VI editor. To do that, I enter VI and then the file name. I'll go to the dtdi cert file and update the name from underscore 2 to underscore 1 and change the revision number from 2 to 1. And then I'll enter colon WQ to save the file. With that fix completed, I'll now attempt to load the configuration again by entering tmsh load sysconfig. When you do this on your system, the configuration load may fail again at a different point, and you'll have to repeat the troubleshooting steps to find out what the problem is. But in this example, we have fixed the issue, so the configuration loads and the system automatically restarts services. Once the services are restarted, we can enter TMSH show sys MCP state. And here we can see that the last config load status no longer shows failure, but success. Additionally, the running phase shows running, and the command prompt shows changes pending as it should. Now go back into the configuration utility and log in. And as you can see, the message has disappeared. And that's it. If you have any other questions or comments, leave them below or send us an email. Thanks for watching.